This is the third video in the series on programming for the Computer Science Principal course. In previous video, we introduced the if statement. In this video, we really want to understand it, especially when it gets more complex, such as nested if statements. Now we're going to look at some examples and also some challenges. If you want to see these explained, stay to the end of this video. Start off looking at the indentation of blocks of code. Here we start off with a simple if statement. You can see, if it's raining, use an umbrella. Now the use umbrella is a block of code and it has an indentation. It has a space between the beginning of the line and beginning of the code. So we know that block is part of the if statement. We can look at some examples now. Here we can see two print statements in Python, part of the if statement. So here prints hello, and again prints both print statements because X is true. You can see that block of code is part of the if statement. In this example, the code is different, although we have the same output. We still have two print statements, but one of them is outside the if statement, and you can see that by the indentation. So our block of code is one print statement, print hello. Print again happens anyway, but that will happen without the if statement being true. So the output the same, but the logic is different. Now if we change this again, you can see now X is false. So because it's false, this code prints again, but not hello. So we can see, because that print statement is outside the code block of the if statement, it will happen. So that indentation is important because we know which code is inside and which code is outside the if statement. And our final example, you can see X equals false. So both print statements are inside the if statement. So there's absolutely no output. So those are four examples where the logic is different. And you can see our block of code is part of the if statement. Now that's important when we want to learn about nested if statements. So a nested if statement. Here we've got an if statement if outside. If that's true, we're going to go through the code that's underneath. On the right we can see an if statement, if rain, print use umbrella. Now what happens if we want to move that if rain if statement inside where our code block is? So let's move that, and you can see now we have a nested if statement. The if rain is inside the if outside if statement. So our block of code includes an if statement. So the inside part is called nested, a nested if statement. So let's look at some examples. So we go back to our if rain statement. You can see we have our print umbrella code block inside. Now that's only relevant if it's outside. So if we put an if outside first of all, then if rain print umbrella will only run if that's true. So we have print umbrella is part of the if rain, and the if rain print umbrella is part of the if outside. They are nested. Here we've got if coffee, boil kettle, add milk, add sugar. So we can see here we have three lines of code that are part of the if statement. You can see they're indented. Here's another example. If buy fruit, choose fruit, pay money, receive change, take fruit. So that's our block of code. You can see it's all indented. But receive change. Is there always change? Well, not always. So we could change that. So we've got if change, receive change. So we've got a nested if statement inside our main if by fruit statement. So you can see receive change is in the block of code underneath if change. So that's nested. And we can see all of that code is a block of code under the if by fruit if statement. So we can look at the code for that. If by fruit, we've got two print statements, then we've got if change. Print receive change will only happen if change is true. And print take fruit, now that will happen the same as the first two print statements, if by fruit is true. It doesn't matter about the change bit. So we can see we've got print choose fruit, print pay money, and print take fruit. They will happen if by fruit is true. Receive change will only happen if change is true. Here's another example. If first day of the month. So we know the first day of the month, number one. Now, it's a new month, we know that. But if it's January, it's also a new year. So we can say, if January, print Happy New Year. Else, it's a new month. Both of those are true if it's the first day of the month. And we decide which one we want. If it's January, if it's true, it's January. So that's an if-else statement that's nested inside an if statement. We can see that block of code. And we have our blocks of code inside the if-else. Now we can look at that in Python. If it's true, we have first day of the month. Then we have the if-else statement. If month equals January, print Happy New Year. Else, print new month. Let's have a look at an example. So we have colors. Colors can be dark or light. So here we have dark blue, light blue. Red, light red. Dark green, light green. So we want to write an if statement that chooses between the six colors. How would we do that? Well, let's go through different stages. Part one, write an if else statement where we print red or blue. So that's quite straightforward. If color is greater than zero, for example, print red, else print blue. Part two, if else statement for dark or light. So that's pretty much the same code, except we've got if shade is greater than zero, print dark, else print light. Now, let's see what happens next. We want to put the color if else statement inside the if and else part of the shade if statement. So with the shade if, we've got the true or false part, the if and the else, and we're going to put the color bit in both parts. So here we've got if shade is greater than zero, got if and else, and we've got the if color greater than zero. Instead of just having red and blue, at the top we've got dark red and dark blue, and bottom we've got light red and light blue. So this is an if else, two if else statements inside an if else statement, so they're nested. Part four, write an if else statement. So now we're going to add the color green. So now we've got if color is greater than zero, print red. We've got an elif, we'll print blue, else we print green. Now we want to change the if else to if elif else in our main code. So here we've got if shade is greater than zero, means they're dark. We've got color greater than zero, red, dark red, less than zero, dark blue, else dark green. At the bottom we've got the same code, but now they're light rather than dark. So that's how we can determine which one of the six colors, dark or light, red, blue or green. So I hope that example explains how we might indent and nest code inside other statements. Time for some challenges. Task 1. Print eat if hungry equals yes and food equals yes. But if food does not equal yes, then print go shopping. Task 2. If food does not equal yes, then print go shopping. But if it does, print eat if hungry equals yes. That's task 2. Task 3. Print either of the 4 statements depending on x and y being equal to either 0 or 1. Okay, good luck with them. When you finish, let's have a look at the solutions and explain the answers. We have task 1. Let's have a look at the code. So if hungry equals yes and food equals yes, print eat. If food does not equal yes, go shopping. So we have an if else inside an if statement. Task 2. If food does not equal yes, go shopping. But if it does, then if hungry equals yes, print eat. So here we've got an if statement nested inside the else part of an if else statement. That was task 2. Task 3, we've got 4 options. So here we've got if x equals 0, then we have an if else with y equals 0, both are 0, or only x is 0, depending on if y is 0. And the else part, when x is 1, is not 0, then if y is 0, then print only y is 0, or both are 1. So you could do this several ways, but here we've got an if else with x, and then we've got the 2 if else's with y. Okay, and finally, just have a quick look at the pseudocode of the nested if statements. So here we've got simple if statement in Python with 2 print statements. So we can put that in pseudocode as we did before. So let's try our nested if statement, if rain, which is nested inside an if outside statement. So here we have our nested if statement in pseudocode. Now here we've got an if else statement nested in an if statement. So we look in pseudocode. Again, we've got our if else statement using display, and that's inside an if statement. So those are the pseudocode versions of the code we've seen during this video. Okay, if you've learned something from that, please give us a like, it helps us a lot. And if you want to know when these videos come out, we're going to continue this series every Sunday and sometimes some short videos for practice, then please subscribe.